This is a video of Buster, a 2-year-old Arab cross gelding. Buster has some experience trotting in hand, but in this video, Les is teaching him to trot over jumps and actually to canter in.
Buster started offering the canter after some of the jumps, so I added a cue by cantering in my own body. I was able to reinforce that cue by rewarding him.
By the end of the session, Les could actually canter from a standstill and Buster would canter next to him. All this happened over the course of about 5 minutes.
In this clip, Kaylee is teaching Buster to play the chair game.
He first discovered the chair game watching the video of Ellen Offstad and her horse Destinatus on YouTube.
Play the chair game, you move away from the horse with a mounted block, jump on the mounting block, and ask the horse to target up next to you in a mounting position.
You can use your hand to show your horse where he needs to move to so that his belly is lined up next to your body. A lot of horses actually don't know where the mounting position is. They often think that you want to ride their rump and their...
As Buster gets better and more confident about lining up, Haley adds other things to the equation, like rubbing him with her leg he's standing there. These are really great preparations for going under saddle, because all this movement simulates the things that will happen when the saddle is on the horse's back.
What's also unique about the chair game compared to other methods for teaching mounting is that the horse elects to line up to earn his porking treat. When it's the horse's idea to line up to get ridden, it's much more likely that he'll have a positive experience, and so will you.
One of the most important things to have for successful riding is really good connection and synchrony between horse and rider. A third great thing about the chair game is that by having the horse follow you, you gain more synchrony between you and the horse as he mimics your movement.
He walks next to you, targeting on the mounting block, and when you step up, he mimics your stepping up, but instead lines up next to you.
Here we see Buster try and line up before Kaylee's ready. Instead of getting frustrated, she funnels his eagerness and takes that energy to get him to trot for the next mountain, something he hadn't done before.
It's a special horse that will actually trot into position for you to get on him. That shows a real understanding and confidence intuition in him. Buster knows he's about to win, and he thinks it's great.
The great thing about the chair game is it provides a natural framework for progression. Earlier, Kaylee was just asking him to line up, then rubbing his side with her leg. Now she's jumping up and resting her full weight across his back, and soon she'll be able to straddle him. Here we see Buster eagerly trot off after Kaylee. That's so great, because earlier, just by taking his energy when he offered it, she shaped a behavior that he now offers regularly. Although Buster is now offering energy in the trot all the time, this game helps to regulate his go and his whoa, because he has to be thinking and stop in the right spot.
Opportunities like this help a young horse figure out the difference between enthusiasm and hyperness. Many young horses are actually afraid of their own canter. They think if they're going fast, that it means they must be running from something. When you play games like this that allow the horse to use their enthusiasm, what you're doing is practicing for performance horseback riding. If you want a horse that can come out and play hard, but isn't going to take off with you at the drop of a hat, it's a good idea to play games like this that allow them to use their enthusiasm and their mind at the same time.
As the game progresses, Kaylee makes changes, like stopping using the mounting block and jumping up from the ground. This not only simulates other real-world situations, but teaches the horse to generalize from one situation to the next.
Now that I'm laying on Buster's back, it's possible to feed him the treat while I'm up there, which teaches him how to flex. It's important for the horse to be supple through the neck, because if the neck is not supple, you cannot disengage the hindquarters.
Here Kaylee continues to increase the difficulty by kneeling up on Buster's back. This can be a scary thing for a lot of horses, because they're not used to having moving creatures above their head. Not only can it be scary, but it can also be very uncomfortable on the horse's back and can challenge their balance. Additionally, it's great to get your head above the horse's head because it mimics the position it will be while you're riding differently from when you're laying across the withers.
Since Buster did so well with everything I asked of him on the left side, I'm now asking him to start allowing me to work from his right side. It takes him a minute to change sides and to change brains, but eventually he figures out how to target on the right side, and I give him a good rub as a reward, and then go back to trying to jump on his back. I'm very impressed with Buster for allowing me to change sides and staying so relaxed. You can actually see him yawning right there. I take that as a good sign and immediately jump up into the straddle position. Again, I'm able to feed Buster a treat while I'm sitting on his back, which works on his flexion. Oftentimes, the young horse is very hesitant to walk off when they're first being ridden, but Buster seems to say, "Okay, well, if you're okay up there, I'm okay," and begins to go say hello to Les. Because I didn't tie my lead rope in a knot to make rings, I go ahead and jump down. I'm very excited about how Buster behaved during this training episode, and I'm looking forward to a lot more fun with him.